Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. In this video, we're going to look at using the lists section for managing lists of personnel or employees. And it's good to have a centralized list as a source of truth, which your form templates can then refer to. But you can also use the list section to manage details associated with, in this case, each person. For example, their contact details, their licenses, competencies, things like that. So we can see here that we've got a list already created of personnel. And if we click on it, it's going to pull up a list of all of the different list items, which in this case are just the different people. So you can see we've got a list of all the different names. And you'll notice that we've added a bunch of what we call list properties. So that's all of these additional columns here. It's actually quite useful for tracking all different details associated with each list item, which in this case is each person. So we can see their date of birth, which is a list, a date property. We have their address, which is a text property. We have their driver's license expiry, and this is a special type of date property. It's a expiry property, and it's great because it's color coding the dates to give us an indication of which licenses, you know, are valid, which ones are overdue in red, or which ones are coming up for renewal in orange. So at a glance, we can get a sense for which licenses may need to be renewed or checked. And what's great about this column in particular, and this list property, is we can set up some automatic notifications at a set interval to remind us, you know, 30 days before this date arrives, or maybe once that date arrives and it's overdue, and we can select a person from our team to receive an email notification automatically. So it helps you just avoid having anyone with an expired license in your team. And then we have another column for the actual driver's license record. So you can upload PDF attachments for any licenses or competencies. This is a column for attachments. And you know, this is a very simple example. We only have a couple of list properties, but you could extend this to have their contact details, their phone number, their email, their next of kin, their preferred emergency contact, things like that. And also extend the licenses to cover different competencies and other licenses that each person may have. A couple last things to note about this list. So if we have a list of personnel set up, yes, we can manage that list of people. We can add new people. We can remove people who may have left our organization. We can manage all of their details here. But what's great about setting it up as a list in Dashpivot is that we can then refer to that list of personnel in our form templates. So if we have a daily report or an inspection or a timesheet, we may want to have a drop-down menu where you can select which people were attending or which person that form is for. That's where you'll want to refer to this list that has been set up of personnel. So that's where it becomes really handy because you could have multiple templates all referring back to the same list. And remember that to get started, you can just import an existing list, just export it from your other program, whether it's Excel or Google Sheets or some other software. Just export it as a CSV file. And then by clicking this button here, you can actually import that into Dashpivot. So that can give you a quick way of setting up that list instantly. And then you can start to populate some of those additional details and then link that to the form templates that you have. So that's how you can manage a list of personnel or employees in the list section in Dashpivot. If you'd like to check out our other functionality and other use cases, head over to the tutorial section on the Dashpivot website. But if you get stuck, you can always reach our live chat team on the website and in the Dashpivot app if you have a specific question or need help with something. So that's all for this video, and thanks for watching.